Hello there, everyone. I am Oversoul 53. This is Oversoul Gaming, and welcome to Let's Replay, let's rewatch Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories. Although this is technically re-Chain of Memories, because this is the because Chain of Memories was originally a Game Boy Advance game that got remade for the PS2, and this is the HD version on PS3 of the PS2 version. So this is the third iteration of this game, and by far the most definitive. I don't want to play this one. Not that it's bad or anything, it's just that I want to hurry up and get to the good ones on the second disc, and, this with its card-based battle system takes a while to get through because of how much grinding you have to do, and I just don't wanna, okay? So we're just gonna go to theater, and we're gonna watch all the cutscenes. We're gonna do Sora first, and then Riku, obviously. Sora's is gonna take longer, so Sora's will probably be split into multiple parts. We will probably do Sora's story in multiple segments. Riku, on the other hand, should only probably take about a half hour to an hour, depending. Now, for those of you that are like, "Aw, just the cutscenes, I was hoping for some gameplay," listen, I'm not a complete asshole, okay? I did throw a little gameplay in here for you, just so that you could see it if you've never seen the PS2 version, or, you know, or something like that, or you just were hoping to see some gameplay. Well, here you go. Here's a little gameplay.
Back off! Back off! Ha! Yeah! Yeah! Heal! Colonel!
When we do Riku's story, I'll throw in a little gameplay from his as well before we start his. So, but first, we must do Sora's. I'll shut up now so you can enjoy the song. Again. Did you enjoy that opening montage with bits from the first game? I bet you did, you sick anime-loving fucks. I'm just kidding. I am also a sick anime-loving fuck. Remember this? It's from the post-credit scene from the first game. We pick up right where we left off.
Along the road ahead lies something you need.
Marluxia, you can't be sneaking up on people like that. You get shot in certain places. Yeah, that's Marluxia.
However,
by the way.
In order to claim it, you must lose something that is dear to you.
I can actually tell what that is in the HD version of the game. It's a doll that looks just like her. By her, I mean Naminé. By the way, she's important. Everybody in this castle is a nobody, and by that I don't mean that they're not important. What I mean is they're the nobodies. For those of you that don't know, you'll find out what a nobody is in not only the next game, but, well, in the movie, the 358 Days Over 2 movie, but also Kingdom Hearts 2, duh, when Yen Sid explains it to them, what nobodies are, but yeah. I've talked a bit about the nobodies already. This castle is filled with them. Naminé is one, she's a special one, with ties to Kairi, and Sora, and his memories, and all the people tied to him. She has special powers because Kairi was a princess of heart, and she lost her heart, and thus, a nobody was born. Kairi, a lot like Roxas, is a very special case when it comes to the nobodies. Not Kairi, goddammit. Naminé. Naminé, like Roxas. Naminé and Roxas are very much similar. Also, this is gonna be weird when Sora talks, because this game, the PS2 version of Chain of Memories, came out after Kingdom Hearts 2, so it was after Haley Joel Osment hit puberty and his voice got deeper, so his voice is gonna be deep in this game. Which is weird, because it takes place right after the first one, so it's gonna be go from high to deep, like he hit puberty in, like, overnight. Literally overnight.
Hey, you think it's okay to barge in?
But we gotta do it, if we can afford the king.
To be fair...
The king? King Mickey's here?
To be fair, Donald's voice...
Something just told me he'd be here, okay?
Donald's voice is a little off in this one, too.
Really? Because now that you mention it, I was kind of thinking the same thing.
Seriously?
Yep, there it is.
Me too. One look at this castle, and I just knew. Our very best friends. They're here.
Yep.
That voice doesn't sound right coming out of Sora in those clothes.
It can't be just a coincidence.
Oh no, Timothy. You don't mean that.
Yep, I had it too. Mm-hmm. I had the exact same feeling.
Gorge! Maybe it's contagious!
Or maybe you're all just stupid.
Something screwy! We gotta go take a look!
Alright.
What? Where are you going?
That way.
Your mama's house.
To the door. Are you scared?
Don't be ridiculous. Come on, let's go, Goofy.
It sounds like...
Hey, fellers, shouldn't we shut the door behind us before we go?
It sounds like Donald's voice actor didn't Sora! Get enough sleep. He's like just barely trudging. Come on,
that's it.
Let's go.
Who are you?
It's Marluxia.
What? Heartless.
Heartless.
Oh, yeah? I'll try some magic. Thunder! Come on! Thunder!
They
Thunder!
Did not bother to smooth the character's outlines in this one.
Come on! Wizard! Fire! Why isn't it working?
I should think it's obvious. The moment you set foot in this castle, you forgot every spell and every ability you ever knew.
How arbitrary.
In this place, to find is to lose, and to lose is to find. That is the way in Castle Oblivion.
Redundant and arbitrary.
Castle Oblivion?
That still doesn't explain why when you wake up in Kingdom Hearts 2, you still don't got all your shit. What happened then? Oh, I forgot it while I was sleeping. Past.
And you will meet people you miss.
I miss?
Don't believe it, it's all lies!
Riku! You mean Riku's here?
I mean, yes, but also no.
If what you want is to find him.
I'm pretty sure he just got, like, phantom raped.
Huh? What'd you do?
I merely sampled your memories.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
I made this.
A card!
To reunite with those you hold dear.
I swear to God.
What's this? A card?
It is a promise for the reunion you seek. Hold the card to open the door, and beyond it a new world.
One of the most goofy things about this one
proceed,
is that
Sora,
they fucking write the cards
to lose and claim
into
anew,
the narrative.
Or to claim anew, only
it's
to
not
lose.
Just a gameplay element. It's not just a gameplay element. The characters actually explain it to him, like, yeah, you gotta use the cards to fight and shit. And, like, what? It's the rules of the castle.
Let's go.
It was just an excuse for Square Enix to try their hands at an action-based trading card game deal hybrid thing. And it worked. Okay, but it's not everyone. A lot of people don't like it. I'm somewhere in the middle. A lot of people love it. A lot of people hate it. I'm like, it's alright. You know, I don't hate it. But it's definitely not my favorite. Sora's like, oh no, this cannot be right. This is Traverse Town. This is a place I've been already. But I was inside castle. Where castle go? Why I in town, not castle. What you see, it not be real. Yeah, it's based off your memories and shit. You know, because the game is called Chain of Memories! You know? Yes, your memories. Nah, man, I was just talking out my ass. And Jimmy's like, yo, Sora, we're down, Goofy Go. Them sons of bitches owe me money. Donald, Goofy, where you be? What did you do with them? They are at the mercy of the cards now. God, what a horrible existence to just be, like, fucking teleported into nothingness, and then basically, in order for you to pop into existence, fucking Sora has to, like, call upon you using a card. Jesus, talk about a fate worse than death. That's, like, Soma level terrifying. I have no mouth and I must scream. I tell you, fucking Kingdom Hearts is fucked up sometimes. And this is actually the game where it starts getting fucked up. You're gonna see organization members straight up murder each other, betrayal. It's gonna be like, as soon as the organization pops into this shit, it goes fucking PG-13. Are you two alright? Where the hell you been at, man? You owe Jiminy money. Donald's like, yo, quit fucking screaming at us, man. We just, all we know is that you opened the door and then poof. Yeah, see, that would suck so much ass. Gee, that doesn't help. No, it doesn't, but what the fuck is there to remember? One minute they're there, and the next they're not. Oh, and look, somebody changed your clothes for you, too. Maybe somebody slipped you a Mickey Finn, then raped you, and put on a new pair of clothes. Maybe that's why you don't remember anything. I mean, that guy in the black coat does look very suspicious. Of course it's the fucking cards! Everything is the cards! For the castle, okay. You don't got a goddamn choice. Donald basically said Sora's useless without them. Yeah, tough words coming from the guy who got knocked the fuck out every battle in the first game. Shit. I'll be fine. I'm not playing. I'm just watching, so it's all good. Alright, Sora's like, I can do it by myself. I'm brave and shit. I'm only 14, but I got the heart of a fucking 25-year-old. Castle Oblivion. Why would you even go inside a place called Castle Oblivion? Like, the name Oblivion should be like a fucking hint, like, do not enter, or else Oblivion. Do you have a death wish? I've got a bad feeling about this. You can't steal Han Solo's line. Or, no, wait. Was that Han Solo? Or was it... Yeah, I think so. How hard could it be to figure out these cards? Well, I'll tell you, buddy. After a while, it gets pretty fucking complicated. It's not hard. It's just, oh my god, I don't have enough CP, so I can't get enough good cards, and then the slights take the first card and the thing away, and then, so then you don't have, if you use too many slights and rely on them a lot, then you won't have them for the fight, and then, like, yeah, sometimes you can get down to a fight with, like, fucking two cards and no health, and you're just fucked. You know. Fighting alone isn't as easy as I thought. Nah, son, it never is. Obviously, this is gonna skip all of the gameplay and just go to different cutscenes. So, you know, in between this cutscene and the last one, there was a lot of running around and fighting Heartless, as you can imagine. And creating rooms. As you saw in the gameplay example, you use the cards you collect in battles to create rooms. And each room is different depending on the card you use to create it. They have a different effect. Like, some of them can be like, oh, there's weak Heartless in here. Some of them can be like, there's a lot of Heartless in here. Some of them can be like, there's a treasure in here. Some of them create save points. You know, Moogle rooms where you trade in cards for CP. That kind of shit. This is worth watching, even if you've already played the Game Boy Advance version, because some of the dialogue has changed, and I think they act like some of the cutscenes are different as well. I think they actually put more into this version. You know, because it's full-length voiced cutscenes and shit. Now, the cutscenes in the worlds are all in subtitles like this. No, you're not in the real Traverse Town. God, try to keep up. I know you're stupid, but come on. It's just an illusion based on memories inside the castle. This castle, it does weird shit to people, okay? And there's actually, you know, it doesn't make a lot of sense now, but there's a really good reason as to why this castle is so weird, you know? And why everybody who goes in here kind of more or less gets fucked over. This castle is actually cursed. That's why it's called Castle Oblivion. It was actually created from the remains of a world that got destroyed by the darkness during the events of Birth by Sleep. But I'll leave you to wait until we actually get to Birth by Sleep to actually see what world and how that, you know, it came to be. Once you finally see it, you'll be like, oh my god, that's fucking crazy. You know, so it's worth, look forward to it. It's a huge fucking reveal, and it's like, oh, holy shit. So see, now of course this Leon is based on his memory, so of course this Leon is a memory Leon that lives within the memory based Traverse Town, so of course he's gonna think it's a real Traverse Town, and he doesn't have a goddamn clue who Sora is, because of course they've never met, because this is not the real Leon. And of course, you know, everybody else on the planet caught on to this right away, but Sora, Donald, and Goofy are fucking ditzes, and they don't know what the like, seriously, come on, how stupid can you be? But the weird thing is, like I said, this is Castle Oblivion, so, oddly enough, oddly enough, he just said Sora's name, as if he does remember him, even though he doesn't. Because like I said, it's not the real Leon, but there's like a, there's a weird, like, it's hard to explain. Since these characters are based off of Sora's memories, and the way that they're being fucked with right now, it's almost like there's kind of like a glitch in the magic that's being used to do this. And it's causing some of the memories to remember the same memories of the real versions of themselves. I don't know. I can't fucking explain it any better than that, honestly. It's, you know, because anime and shit. That's all of... Yeah, how about them apples? Ain't nothing wrong with your memory, just something wrong with the fucking... you know... Something wrong with the villain's plot. There's a lot of holes in it, if you know what I mean. It's Yuffie! Leon Yuffie. Some kind of... Oh, some uncanny kind of power here. She asked us for to be in the looking into it. Yeah, it's pretty uncanny that fake versions of the real you would remember someone that you've never met. Of course, Sora, Donald, and Goofy would remember them because they're remembering based off the real ones, but... I suddenly have a headache. It's probably by trying to fucking think of a way to explain this nonsense. I gave myself a headache trying to explain this shit. You guys are lucky I love you. That's how convoluted Kingdom Hearts gets. It's so convoluted that I got a headache trying to explain it. Like, come on. I still love it, though. Not gonna lie. My favorite game series of all time. I mean, people love Metal Gear Solid, and that's pretty goddamn convoluted as well, so... Just something about the Japanese. They know how to write a confusing story. Especially out of chronological order. Thankfully, these PS3 versions are more or less in chronological order-ish, except that after Kingdom Hearts 2, it jumps way back to Birth by Sleep. Which is 10 years before the first game. But, so basically Leon just taught Sora some combat moves. Fight some real battles, wow. Harsh words. He gave Sora a Simba summon card. Holy shit. Have you forgotten me too? Nah. Yep, it's like she remembers but doesn't. It's weird for everybody, isn't it? Funny thing is, these characters in this world are kind of like the only ones that remember them. You know, just in Traverse Town. I want to say the reason for that, like, and then every other world after that, it's like they're meeting for the first time. Even though it was half like that for them here. And I want to say the reason is because... I don't know, because they're Final Fantasy characters? I don't fucking know. I'm going to assume the reason is because Traverse Town is the first world they go to, so a lot of the memories are still very fresh at this point, so of course they're gonna remember them, you know. So yeah. We may never meet again, but we'll never forget each other. There's no way he should know that, because, you know... It's very weird for everybody. Also, this is a fate worse than death for the memory people in these worlds inside Castle Oblivion, because these people aren't real. And, like, their existence, I think, is more or less wiped out after a while. And, they're forced to live a fake life. And especially for these ones in this world, where they are, like, tormented by the fact that they have memories that they shouldn't have. Like, what a shitty existence. Like I said, everything about Castle Oblivion is just fucked. I guess they kind of explain it here that Sora's memories are affecting the memories of these memories. Hey, Sora, your memories are affecting the memories of memories. Yo, dog, I heard you like memories. Yeah, it's an illusion, something your memories. No fucking shit! How long does it take you to catch on to the thing that was, like, very obvious from the moment you stepped foot in this place? Sora is a goddamn Mary Sue. Yeah, see, they don't fucking get it. And they won't understand what you mean. I think this is why in every other world they go to after this one, they just pretend like they're meeting everyone for the first time again. Because either their memories are starting to get lost and they are meeting them again for the first time, or because they're just like, well, I don't want to go through that bullshit again. Might as well just pretend like we don't know each other. Right, yeah. I'm gonna take a better look around. Then go have a walk around town. They're heartless, but that's no problem for you. Not at all. So you know I can fight. Of course. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna try to be a little bit faster about getting through the worlds and their text-based nonsense. Well, Sid knows Sora, but he doesn't understand why he knows Sora. And he's like, wait, what am I saying? I don't know you. You look like a Sora, with that spiky hair and baggy pants. Sora's like, I get it now, it's all cool. And he's like, ah, so you've heard of me. Of course, and then Sid's like, arrogant. A friend of mine's supposed to be somewhere in this castle or town. Any others? Heartless. Can't even take two steps without getting attacked. Heartless. The Blaze's the worst. Bell Tower, jumbo-sized Heartless. Wow, could it possibly be the guard armor? If you value your hide, you'll get out of here while the getting's good. About to be too late in a couple of seconds. Maybe we should leave. Hell no. Sora's like, don't you want to see the big Heartless? And Donald's like, no, we don't. Well, too late. You lingered too long. Here it comes. Ah, the bell! Look out. Be careful, Sora. It's gonna fall from the sky. Here it comes. Hey, look at that! Now, here's where I call bullshit. And this is why they should have, like... The one thing that they should have did in the HD version of Chain of Memories for PS3 is match the color palette swaps from the final mix version of Kingdom Hearts, because it doesn't make sense, if these worlds are based on Sora's memories, that the Heartless would be different colors. You know? Because... Now, those colors right there were the original colors from the PS2 version of Kingdom Hearts, but the final mix version had the, like, red, gray, and blue, or, yeah, red, gray, and blue one, or red, gray, blue, and yellow, or whatever, multicolored one. So here's how I like to keep continuity. This is the way I write it off. The Heartless are different colors because they're just memory-based versions of the Heartless from his adventures. So, they're not real Heartless, is the way I'm looking at it. Like, there are no real Heartless in the castle. Well, that's not true. The last world that you visit in Castle Oblivion is Castle Oblivion. It's part of it, and there are Heartless in that section. So they are very much real. But, I like to think that the Heartless in the memory worlds are just memory Heartless, and that is why the colors are different. That's my excuse. Yep, I may not remember you, but I know you in my heart, and so on and so forth. La-di-da, mushy-gushy, and all that fun stuff. Alright, toodles, goodbye! Alright, sayonara, see you later. Adios and all that jazz. Aerith's like, yo, Sora, hold up. What's up? I don't have all the answers, but I had to tell you something. Your memories created this town, right? That's what the guy who gave me the card said. If that's true, then this town is just a figment of your mind. And so what are we? No shit! But fucking Sora with the stupid and the not understanding of the plot and such, you more like, okay, with all due respect, he fucking deserves what happens to him in this game for his being just blatant idioticness. But I'm not really me. I like how Aerith realizes that she's not real. Like, the only memory that realizes that she's not real. That she's just a memory. Congratulations for being self-aware. That's fucking dangerous. That is even more... That's like... You want to talk about Soma level fucked up? That's like in Soma when you find out what you are. Even though you fucking saw it coming a mile away. And it's not the real plot twist anyways. I'm just another illusion. The truth is out of my reach. The plot twist in this game is a bit further on. They tell you this shit early because they're trying to set the pace and show how fucking slow Sora is to catch on to stuff, which shows exactly why he falls so easily for the trap that the organization sets for him in this castle. Yeah, I'll be right there. I'm just saying goodbye for to the Aerith. Well, I'd better be go. Ooh. And she has disappeared! Dun dun dun. Well then. These guys didn't see her either. That's the spooky, mysterious thing about it. He was talking to her. But Donald and Goofy didn't see her at all. It looked like Sora was just standing there talking to himself. What could it possibly mean? My theory is that it wasn't actually the memory Aerith, that it was just Naminé sending Sora a message in the form of Aerith. You know, someone that he knew and trusted, so that, I think it was her, kind of her way of warning Sora of what's to come, because what the organization forces her to do to him, she's not happy with. She doesn't want to do it. But... they force her to. She doesn't have a choice. Hello again, Marluxia, you rapist.
Well, Sora, did you enjoy meeting your memories?
Yeah, it was good to see everyone.
No, it wasn't. But it was a disaster.
What do you really want from me?
You ruined their existence. Axel! My favorite!
Hello!
Everybody's favorite, for the most part, anyways.
What do you want?
No hogging the hero.
He's like a more badass version of Reno
perhaps
from
like
Final Fantasy VII.
Perhaps I
same
would.
Voice actor.
My show now, Keyblade
Master.
And his
powers are fire!
Who am I? Oh, my name's Axel. Got it memorized?
Best element.
Sure.
Fire.
Good. You're a quick learner.
Plus, I just love his snarky witticism.
Sora, now that we're getting to know each other better...
God, he's badass. I also like how he's kind of like a double agent.
Don't you go off and die on me now.
Axel's friendship with Roxas is very important to him, so he kind of plays a double agent in the organization because Roxas means more to him than his loyalty to the organization. So there's always something...
Another one?
He always has an alternate agenda in everything that's going on. He's always behind the scenes doing pulling the strings and doing his own shit.
Kind of looks like the card you used when you made Traverse Town.
Then I guess we're going to need it to keep going.
No, you think?
That's right.
Of course, Axel! He can't be defeated so easily. He's Axel.
Did you really think after that introduction, I would give up oh so easily?
You were testing us.
And you passed. Congratulations, Sora. You're ready now. Ready to take on Castle Oblivion. You will need to follow your memories. Trust what you remember and seek what you forget. Then you will find someone very special.
Everybody talks in riddles in this game.
You mean King Mickey and Riku?
Maybe. Maybe not.
You will just have to give some more thought to who it is that's most important to you.
Could it possibly be Naminé?
Our most precious memories lie so deep within our hearts that they're out of reach. But I'm sure that you can find yours, Sora.
Why me?
What is it?
You have lost sight of the light within the darkness, and it seems that you've forgotten that you forgot.
No, he didn't.
The light within darkness?
This is what you call psychological seed planting.
Would you like me to give you a hint?
Axel just inceptioned him, basically. Planted an idea in his head.
Sora, do you need it?
To set him on a specific path. Without actually, you know, doing the whole...
I'm gonna figure it out for myself.
Going inside his dreams thing.
If you're in my way...
Just memories.
We'll protect you.
So almost the same thing.
Good answer. Just what I'd expect from the Keyblade Master.
It's exactly what you guys wanted to happen. He just let him... Congratulations.
But be forewarned. When your sleeping memories awaken, you may no longer be who you are now.
I like how Axel basically leads him on the path that sends him to his near downfall, and then at the end gives him, like, ominous advice. Like, hey, basically, buddy, I just kind of screwed you, but at the same time, be careful.
What's wrong, Jiminy?
And Sora was dumb enough to fall for it.
Well, you see, what Axel said back there worries me.
Yeah, because you're actually smart.
What could he have meant by, you may no longer be who you are?
I may no longer be me. How can I be anyone else?
Of course. Still, you can't be too careful.
Yep. Feels like just about anything could happen here in Castle...
I like how Sora just glosses over it.
Castle Oblivion! Oh, yeah! Now I remember.
We'll be okay. Whatever it is they're cooking up, we'll be able to handle it together.
Course we will. Like that creepy castle we explored together. The one with all those weird contraptions.
Hollow Bastion.
When was that?
Like a fucking day
I
ago?
I don't remember. What was it called?
Or two?
Gorge. Oh, it was, Holler? Sorry, I can't remember.
What? Stop goofing around!
Goofy, sure you didn't make it up?
I like how Goofy is the one that remembers what really happened, and the other two have already forgot. Something that was, like, very recent from just the end of the previous game, almost. Like, come on, guys. For real? Oh, well, I guess it was a while ago, because we did do the Hades Cup afterwards, and the idea is that those cups, take place over multiple days. That's why, like, the scenery changes after so many rounds. Oh, so, yeah, now we're in Wonderland, well, Memory Wonderland, and Goofy's like, hey, somebody's coming! See, so I don't know, they already forgot Hollow Bastion. So I don't know if it's so much that they just pretend that they're meeting everyone again for the first time, or they literally just forgot all everything already, and now all these worlds are new to them again. Something along those lines, I guess. What do you mean, off with your head? Oh, my fur and whiskers! Anyways, Jesus, look at him go. Off with his head? This is my favorite line right here. For such a peaceful looking place, it sounds pretty dangerous. Yeah. I like how in this game Sora puts emphasis on the hold on, off with his head. Like, wait a minute. Decapitation? In a kid's game? You don't say. At least all the cutscenes in these worlds are fucking short, for the most part. Looks like some kind of get together. What's the occasion? A beheading. It's the trial. Yeah, Donald, it's the trial. The charges. This time, instead of stealing the Queen's heart, she's charged. Basically, we're in the same fucking scenario, but this time she's being charged with stealing the Queen's memories. Aiding the heartless. Fiddlesticks, she says. Yeah. Ooh, that's a naughty word for someone of your Britishness. The evidence is... I forgot, that's the evidence. Wow, again, would not hold up in a real court. First of all, it's not possible. Well, never mind, this is Kingdom Hearts, it's whatever, everything is possible. I was gonna say, it's not possible to steal a memory, but here we are in Chain of Memories, where the whole fucking plot of the game is about Sora having his memories rearranged. So, yeah, I guess that is kind of... what am I even thinking? I keep forgetting, this is anime and Disney. Logic need not apply. A brazen thief. How about you go brazen yourself, you fucking stuck-up bitch? Let us all run. Well, that's some horse shit. The trial is a farce. Yeah, I'm so glad he said exactly. Thank you for speaking my mind. How dare you suggest that someone didn't do the thing that they didn't do? Of course I don't know who the real culprit is. But at the same time, I really don't care. Off with all of our heads. You bitch, I have a keyblade. What the hell are they even remotely worried about? Just shoot a fireball at her ass. That was a stupid move. Of course not, you moron. Yeah, it was unnecessary. You could have just knocked them all the fuck out and then took Alice and ran. The Queen of Hearts is a villain. Why even try to help her? Yeah, the cards. We fought the cards and we won. Yay. Alice, go bye-bye. Yep, she's gone. Perhaps she did, but you won't! Time to skedaddle. I like how Donald's like, we've been trumped, as if this game had the foresight to the fucking current year elections. I know that's not what it means, I'm just making a joke. Who's that little Chris about there, Policiai? Back in the forest with the mushrooms and flowers. Yay, drugs. I ain't no damn thief. The hell's the matter with you? He wanted to say... to show off. Yeah, that's about right. More like it. Whoa! Hello, Cheshire Cat. It's the Kitty Mow. Feeling better after that mad dash, are we? Oh, but you're not out of the woods yet. Yes, wait. Ah, this whole place is fucking screwy. The Queen's a stickler for justice. She won't forget you till she remembers. She won't stop hounding you till you get her memory back. Did she forget because she remembers? Does she remember that she forgot? It doesn't matter, I suppose. I don't know, I think we ought to just stay away from her. I think we ought to just go fucking kick her ass. Knock some sense into her, knock her off that pedestal of hers. If the Queen catches her again, it's off with... Well, you know. I guess we'd better do something about the Queen. That's what I'm saying, man! Let's go fucking tie her in a sack and throw her in the river. You should do something, but you don't have to do anything. Huh? Yeah, exactly. If you can't remember something, it's like it never happened. Likewise, if something never happened, you can't remember it. Try too hard to remember, and your memory might lie to you. I don't know why I'm doing these stupid voices for everybody. Like, I'm not even trying to get even remotely close to the actual voice. I'm just doing random stupid voices. That's all I'll say. The rest is for you to figure out. I'm in a pretty hyper mood today. Perfect time to be recording this nonsense. Oh, fiddlesticks. Tick-tock goes the clock. Hey, I pushed that bed. I call a farce. If this world's really based off my memories, that bed should be pushed in. And where the fuck is the table? Let's take a look around! I have found you, my tasty morsel. Uh-oh. Dude, just fucking... stab her in the face with the tip of your keyblade. If you know what I mean. Okay. I sentence you to... Uh-oh, she just got Men in Blacked. Yeah. Looks like that memory got stolen again. What in the world am I doing? Confound it, I can't remember! That's so funny. God, another like, false person that's suffering a fate worse than death thanks to the fucked upness of this castle. God, life just sucks for everybody in these false worlds. I'll tell you what, though. Yep, here's another heartless. Now this I can't complain about because this is the good fucking colors for this one. Why would you do pink and purple? I mean, why? They're checker pieces. Good God. You there! All of you! What is the meaning of this? Where did that creature come from? Fuck if I know, bro. Ain't hiding shit. I like how Alice is the smart one in this situation, though. Seize them! Uh-oh. Please, Your Majesty, wait! Yeah, convince her that she commanded us to destroy the creatures, and then we're all good. Remember, kids, lying will get you out of trouble. Especially if your parents have bad memories. Yeah. Clever girl. Yeah, you totally did. Don't be ridiculous. I never forget anything. Yeah, that's right. That's right. Awaken the arrogance within her. She'll just act like she remembers what you're talking about just so that she doesn't seem stupid. Fucking... Pride cometh before the fall. Yeah, that was close, huh? Way to go. I never would have thought of lying. Try too hard to remember it, your memory might lie to you. Something, something, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, it's basically what I just said. Her arrogance and such. Pretty clever. What's wrong, Sora? Ain't nothing wrong. I guess you'll be safe now. And the queen won't give us any more trouble. Nope, no sorry, Boba Fett. After all, we just got rid of the Heartless like she commanded. Of course, Goofy's an idiot. So he's been fooled into thinking that it's true as well. I like how Donald wants to fight just because Goofy remembered something that wasn't true. Like, ah, put up your dukes, you idiot, and I'm gonna knock you even more stupid.
Huh? What's the matter?
It's that creepy castle that I was talking about earlier. I know I didn't imagine it.
Because you didn't.
Because that was the castle where Sora had to use the Keyblade to free Kairi's heart.
And that's where also Roxas was born!
Then he just disappeared. And I was so worried. How could I ever forget that?
Oh, it was when I turned into a Heartless. Wait, that happened in a castle?
Yeah.
You forgot that? Cause I remember perfectly.
Then what's it called?
That's easy, it was.
Uh-huh.
Somebody help me. Is it in your journal?
It should be.
Every word. I finished the first volume right before we got to this castle. Now then, if I can just find it. Oh, here we go. Let's have a look. Oh, how could it be?
What's the matter?
Oh, my entries, they're gone. Every page is blank.
Dun, 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 Ziploc thickens.
How could this have happened? I'm so careful with the journals.
I like how the music picks up right after that, too.
All that hard work is gone.
The journal's blank. What's going on?
Not good stuff. Very crazy, very bad stuff. And this girl right here, she got a lot to do with most of it. But it ain't her fault.
Something's screwy. Journal pages don't trust us.
It's because...
What if...
Magic.
It's more things.
And such.
Huh?
Goofy was telling us about another castle we'd been to. But none of us really remembers it. Do you think? Could it be that we don't remember because we're losing our memories?
Losing our memories?
Ding, 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 ding. We have a winner.
Remember what that mystery fella said? In this place, to find is to lose. And to lose is to find. It must have been our memories he was talking about losing. Mm-hmm.
So if we keep going... we'll lose more. Guess it really is Castle Oblivion.
Oblivion!
So the higher we go, the more we'll forget.
Indeedioso, Donald Ducky Boy.
Does that mean everything and everybody will be forgotten?
Riku and Kairi too.
Do you want to go back?
It would
Don't worry,
be
Phil
the
Arms.
Smart thing to do.
We might forget about where we've been or what things we've seen, But we won't forget who our friends are.
I don't know.
Come on, Sora. When you turned into a Heartless, did you forget about me and Donald?
Of course I didn't.
There you go. No matter what happens, you won't forget your friends.
Oh.
Friends. Friendship. Yay. Dancing flamingos.
You're right.
Poppycock.
Thank you, Goofy.
Goofy.
So it just gets into that to make you forget about your friends.
Then I guess...
then we are nothing to be scared of. Let's go!
Goddamn right!
But when I turned into a Heartless, who was the one who took forever to notice and kept clobbering me?
Well then...
how come you couldn't forget about that?
Comedy. All right. It looks like Agrabah is the next world, but we're gonna go ahead and wait until the next episode to tackle that. So anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I am Oversoul 53. This is Oversoul Gaming. You've been fantastic, and I will catch you, possibly on another day, definitely another time, and likely in another video. Okay, goodbye.